Well, even when the lights flash on the safety car, it brightens everything up, doesn't it? And you will see when they go around the circuit, the big screens really brighten up the sky. And even some of the floodlights are on here. They have certain floodlights are part of the circuit. It really is that sort of horrible day. But we can't say we weren't warned. The weather forecast throughout the weekend has been saying it's going to be wet on Sunday, and it would come about 8 o'clock, and that's exactly what it did.
Good to see Mark Webber there, of course, former famous Formula One driver, 2015 FIA World Endurance Champion, a massive, massive fan of MotoGP. He'd have loved to have seen his great friend Valentino Rossi riding here. They're a very close relationship, Rossi and Mark Webber. Unfortunately, Valentino Rossi, as we know, sidelined through injury, but Mark Webber still, well, literally soaking up the atmosphere. It's soaking on the grid down there right now, but he's a very, very big fan of MotoGP, is Mark Webber.
Maverick Viñales, three of those wins have come this season, of course, Qatar and Argentina. Then he won in Le Mans. Then he hit a bit of a tough old period, but he came back big style in Silverstone 2 weeks ago when he almost pipped Andrea Dovizioso to victory on the very last lap of the race. Dylan.
Yeah, guys, let me just bring you down onto the grid now. I think we need to hear from some riders. Jack, conditions, I mean, they look a lot worse than in the warm-up this morning.
Yeah, there's a lot of standing water down that back straight. It looks as though there's a lot of standing water. You know, it'll be a little bit scary on the first lap. But no, on the brighter side, it looks like, you know, the wind's coming from in front of us here on the straight, and it looks a little bit lighter out there. I mean, it's never going to be dry, but at least hopefully get rid of some of that standing water. But the track's very slippery, it's going to be a hard one. You know, 28 laps around there, it's going to be a long one. But we'll do our best.
But of course, you are a race winner in the wet. I mean, surely there must be some little hope, at least for a podium.
I mean, we got to get through the first lap first, and we'll see where we are. You know, we were an underdog before that win, and we're still an underdog now. So, you know, we'll just do our thing. And I normally don't mind a little bit of the wet conditions, but we're just going to have to find our rhythm out there. And just try and stay safe. I think that's the biggest thing, you know, watching Moto3 and Moto2. The smart guys finished, you know, and those both who've won Romano and Moto3 and also Domi and Moto2, I mean, they both rode really, really technically and really, really smart races. So, try and copy those guys, no real mistakes, and we'll see what happens.
Thanks a lot, Jack. Good luck.
Yeah, Jack Miller will start from the middle of the fifth row of the grid. Of course, nobody will forget just over a year ago his magnificent victory in very similar conditions at Assen in Holland.
Yeah, Jack Miller sounded pretty apprehensive, wasn't he? He said
he did,
the conditions.
Did, yeah.
I mean, Jack's normally pretty bubbly, isn't he, on the grid? But he sounded quite nervous down there. And I imagine it's pretty tense for all those riders with these tricky conditions.
It is. Yes, certainly. I mean, it certainly has changed quite a lot. I mean, you know, one man who can tell us is Loris Baz. I've just come across two Loris. Loris, I mean, everyone will look at your warm-up this morning, probably have you down as a favourite. But realistically, how similar is it to this morning?
Well, the conditions are pretty much the same than this morning, but we just have 28 laps to do, so it's pretty long. The good thing is I'm starting in the back, so I have a long way to do to come back in the front, but yeah, we had a good pace this morning. I think, this kind of race, you just have to be clever, and if you stay on your wheel until the end, usually you have a good position, and we will try. The pace was good, so I hope I can get the same pace. If I can get the same pace, I'm sure I can make a strong race.
Then starting further back, Loris, I mean, is it quite good having those guys as a bit of a reference in these early laps?
Yeah, it's maybe too much in the back because 16 is it's a pretty long way, and with the water that is on track, you cannot see anything in the first lap. So I'll try to make a good start. If I can overtake a few guys in the first lap, will be good and helpful for the race, because it's never easy to start that way on the bike, but yeah, for sure, then you have the good reference and guys that are fast, like Andrea Jorge. I also have Jack here, so we know the guys that are strong on the wet, but the stronger is the one who stays on the wheel.
Okay, fantastic. Thank you, Loris. Good luck.
Yeah, it looked very useful this morning, did Loris Baz. As so rightly says, though, he is starting a fair bit back. But as we've seen in the other race, I'm sorry Jack Miller gave away the race winners when he said that, for anybody that had recorded you've got to stay patient.
There's a sporting hero.
This is a man you wouldn't argue with, would you?
What an Italian sporting hero that man was, Francesco Totti, an Italian footballing legend. for the national team and also for AS Roma, where he spent his entire club career. He's another one who's a very close friend of Valentino Rossi, as well as a few disappointed celebrity fans, as well as a few disappointed, well, a few, I say thousands and thousands of Valentino Rossi fans gathered all the way around the world that are not seeing him ride this weekend.
Guys, just onto the grid once more. I'm down here with Lucio Ceccanello from the LTR team. Lucio, we've seen before, Cal, he can win in these kinds of conditions. We know he has the finger problem, but do you think it could happen today?
Well, there will be a lot of battle in the front. Everybody saw Marquez really, really fast this morning, and also I expect Petrucci and Loris Bass, even Jack Miller, they for sure will attack, you know, because it's a great chance also for them. So it will be a very tough race. For us, of course, Cal is another one that he wanted to attack, but I believe that, especially the first part of the race, we suggested him to, you know, to keep watching, because it's quite a delicate situation. We have east wind, it's coming, it's bringing a lot of humidity with from the sea, so it's a salt humidity with salt, and it's making the asphalt very slippery.
Thank you very much, Lucio, good luck.
That's interesting what Lucio Ceccanello said, wasn't it? Coming in from the sea and making it even more slippery. Here is Cal Crutchlow, that unfortunate accident to his, to his finger when he sliced the tendon. He must have been cutting that cheese pretty hard to do that. He did ride a bike the next day. And I think, it's, as Matt said, it's just affecting the way he holds onto the handlebars. That one podium position for Cal Crutchlow in Argentina, but he had a good race in Silverstone as well. Rode with the leaders the whole race and finished in fourth place. Well, here is another former Misano winner, Alvaro Bautista.
Yeah, good day yesterday for the Aspar Ducati team. They had both of their riders in Q2 for only the second time this season. Dylan?
Guys, I'm just going to bring you down once more. I'm down here with Mark Webber now. Mark, these conditions, I mean, you're used to four wheels, that's slippy enough. What do you think of the guys on two wheels that have to face this?
Tough. I mean, obviously the concentration is going to be absolutely complete maximum. They've got a long race. The race will be longer because obviously it's taking a long time to do the laps, right? So you see a little bit of clear sky in the distance, but I'm not sure it's going to make a difference today in terms of the track conditions. So let's see. Wise heads, and then we've got a couple of fast guys coming from the back, obviously Petrucci, Miller, you know, these guys that don't care about the championship. So be a good race.
Do you think anyone can beat Marquez?
Yes, I think they can. I mean, it's a long, long 50 minutes. So let's see. It's going to be the top 2 inches. Mindset today is going to be crucial for the victory.
Right, thank you very much, Mark.
Mark Webber. This is Hector Barbera. We saw a Carol Abram just before then. Carol Abram was a faller in the warm-up this morning. Good old smile from Hector Barbera. Again, a former winner here in the 250cc class. He's fighting for his future, isn't he?
Yeah, he seems pretty relaxed. There's a few tense faces down the grid there. Some Rossi fans with the bright yellow Stetsons. There is Jack Miller, looking a little bit more relaxed now than what he was when he spoke to Dylan a few moments ago. While Mark Webber actually was talking to Dylan, there's some pictures emerging on social media of Valentino Rossi talking to Italian TV from his house in Tivoli.
With his cat.
With his cat in the background. Brilliant.
Just brilliant, wasn't it? Yeah. Superb graphics around the circuit. Aldi Drudi, well known for more helmets design, but look at that. That is just beautiful. And all the way around the circuit, of course, it's such a mark of respect to the late, great Marco Simicelli, and to celebrate the birth of the Misano circuit. That first Grand Prix, as I said, back in 1980.
I think Loris Baz is going to be up for this one. He was strong in that warm session this morning, Nick. Fourth he was in the flag-to-flag race here a couple of years ago. His best ever MotoGP result. Very, very strong. All of his top five finishes, three of them in the MotoGP World Championship, have come in wet conditions. So keep an eye on Loris Baz, who's also riding for his future. Seems he's very, very vulnerable at the Avincia Ducati team. No surprise to see the race being declared a wet race.
It's about the easiest decision race direction I've had to make
all
today.
Season,
I would imagine. Well, the grid lines up. 22 riders line up for this round 13. We're coming up to the two-thirds stage of the MotoGP World Championship. Not been an easy weekend for Jonas Folger. Of course, he missed the previous round after that big, big crash in the warm-up at Silverstone a couple of weeks ago.
Jonas Folger giving an indication of how tricky the conditions are. I've never seen anybody in September in Misano on the grid wearing a woolly hat.
No, that's true. Paul Espargaro, it appears, has gone out on his second machine then. Dylan, eagle-eyed Dylan, said that he came back into a pit lane and swapped over. So we keep an eye on him and the KTM.
He's on a good run at the moment, Paul Espargaro. Point scoring finishes in four of his last five races, one of them being last time at Silverstone, when he crashed, of course, straight after the chequered flag.
Yeah, now does that count as a crash or not? We're having this discussion this morning on the crash statistics. Tito Rabat, news for him. Vintia next year, he'll be on a Ducati, leaving the Mark VDS team. He is a former Moto2 winner, and I've got to say, he's coming into a little bit of form at last, isn't he, Tito Rabat, on the Honda in the MotoGP class?
Yeah, and confirmed earlier on this weekend that he's on the move to the Reale Aventure Ducati team. The only place left on the grid now for Ducati is to be decided in Aragon in a couple of weeks' time.
Quickly, something on the tyre front, guys. We understand everyone is on the soft option wet, but I'm down here with Piero Taramasso from Michelin. Piero, in these conditions, how quickly will they be up to working temperature?
In this condition, I think it will take 4 or 5 laps at least, because we saw already this morning was about the same condition. So after 5-6 laps, front and rear, they will be in temperature, and then they can push a little bit more hard. The hard exercise is at the beginning. You have to push quite a bit to get the temperature in the tire, but not too much, because if you push too much, the tire is not ready, so you will crash.
Dovizioso in dreamland, two in a row, his 115th Grand Prix victory. Valentino Rossi wins here in Hatton.
Marquez wins here in Bruno.
Dovizioso versus Marquez.
Marquez coming again.
So here we go, Marquez, they almost done.
Dovizioso stands firm.
Dovizioso's going to win here in Austria.
Ducati have done it again.
Round 12, British Grand Prix.
Look at the weather.
Wheel to wheel between Dovizioso and Vinales.
He has done it again.
Oh, disaster for Marquez.
Dovizioso got the crush.
Surely he's going to win a classic Battle of Britain.
And he has opened up a 9-point lead in the World Championship. He won the Battle of Britain. He won the Battle of Italy when they're in Mugello. Can he win the Battle of Misano? Andrea Dovizioso, he is on that front row of the grid. He is in the middle of that front row of the grid for this round 13 of the 18-round MotoGP World Championship. Those three top men in the championship are on the front row of the grid. Third fastest, Marc Marquez, the current world champion. In the middle, Andrea Dovizioso. But in pole position for just the fourth time this season, as he chases his fourth Grand Prix victory of the season, it's Maverick Vinales. So welcome back to Misano, round 13 of the 18-round MotoGP World Championship. Front row of the grid, Vinales, Dovizioso and Marquez.
Cal Crutchlow heads row 2 ahead of Jorge Lorenzo and the rookie Johann Zarco.
Row 3, Danny Pedrosa, the race winner last year. Danilo Petrucci, great in the wet, and Aleix Espargaro.
Bautista, the Ducati wildcard, Michele Pirro and Carol Abraham on all Ducati row 4.
Row 5, Hector Barbera, Jack Miller, remember Assad last year, and Loris Bass, so impressive in the warm-up.
Folga, Paul Espargaro and Tito Rabat, that's your sixth row of the grid. Row 7, Scott Running, he's got good form in the rain conditions. Tough weekend for Suzuki, Rins and Iannone, 20th and 21st. Back row of the grid, the two Brits, Bradley Smith in 22nd and Sam Lowes rounding out row number 8.
So good afternoon to you, I'm Nick Harris, alongside me Matt Burke down in pit lane, Dylan Gray. This is going to be a long, arduous battle in the rain and in the wet. The three men that lead the championship are on the front row of the grid. How hard will they dare to push in these conditions? Are we going to see a surprise winner?
Sometimes it's not all about horsepower. Sometimes it comes down to brain power. This is going to be a really mentally demanding, potentially 50-minute exercise for all these riders. Who can keep their calm? Who can be smooth in these tricky conditions? These races, as we know, can be pivotal in the World Championship. Will we see a shock result? As Nick said, Loris Bass, Scott Redding, Danilo Petrucci, Jack Miller have all great records in wet weather conditions.
There are those championship positions. Dovizioso leads Marquez by 9, Vinales by 13, a Rossi, the absent Valentino Rossi, and his cat by 26
point. Cracking banner there. Forza Ducati, of course, there at Borgo Panigale Workshop, not a million miles away from this Misano circuit. Great support then for the world championship leader, Andrea Dovizioso. What a moment in his career. An Italian rider on an Italian motorcycle leading the world championship, coming into an Italian Grand Prix.
Dylan, down there in pit lane. Are we in for a big surprise?
Extremely tough to say, I think, but you know, considering what's happened in the last couple of races, you certainly can't rule it out. I think the good news is it's not raining as heavily as it was in Moto2, so with any luck, conditions should at least not get more treacherous than they are now. I think that's that would be the biggest problem that they might have out there. So, fingers crossed, it's looking good so far.
Look at the spray down the back straight. Danny Pedrosa had to take a big swerve to his right. He basically couldn't see where he was going at one stage, so he came out. Well, Rossi might not be here, Nick, but look at that. Almost 97,000 fans have still packed into this Misano World Circuit, Marco Simoncelli. So full credit to all of you for braving these conditions and still coming, when for many of them the main attraction. We know about what Rossi's support is like, is unfit to ride here. So that's an absolutely cracking crowd under the circumstances.
There you go, Pedrosa 2016, Marquez 2015, Lorenzo 2014.
So here they go, they'll be jamming that front brake on, trying to get some temperature into those steel brake discs. Maverick Vinales pumping that front brake a couple of times, there he goes again as he comes to the grid. Lynn Jarvis, anxious faces all around the pit lane.
This will be no Sunday afternoon jaunt. This is going to be tough and demanding. It's round 13 of the 18 round MotoGP World Championship. We wait for the green flag to appear at the back of the grid. Here we go. The prodigal son may not be here, but the MotoGP family are, and they're ready to rock and roll in the rain.
We're underway then here in Misano. Andrea Dovizioso got a great start from second place on the grid, but Marquez got an even better one from third. Mark Marquez is going to get the whole shot. Is that Lorenzo charging up the inside? Lorenzo got a great start from row two. Jorge Lorenzo hits the front. Marquez in second place. Dovizioso pushed back to fourth with Maverick Vinales charging. There's a few out wide at turn number two, but they're all safely through, and it is Lorenzo that leads.
Well, what a brave move by Jorge Lorenzo in these conditions.
Somebody's down at the top. Carol Abraham's down at turn number three. He's the first man to crash out in this race. Abraham's race over.
You're meant to be taking it easy in this first lap, chaps. Lorenzo up the inside of Marquez. That was brave. Through the very fast turn seven, down towards the difficult turn eight.
So it's Lorenzo that leads. Dovizioso not close enough to attack Marquez then on the brakes. Petrucci trying to pick up Jack Miller a little bit further down in the field. Lorenzo, Marquez, Dovizioso, Vinales. Then crutch though, it was Carol Abraham who crashed out at turn number three. Johann Zarco there in sixth place, so he held his grid position. Alex Espargaro, Petrucci trying to fight his way through. Jack Miller did have a good start, didn't he? Miller has come from 14th place inside the top 10 very quickly.
Up the back straight through the Cavoni curve, even in these conditions, around 260 kilometres an hour, you really can't see through the spray. And it gets tighter and tighter through 12, 13, and then down to the first gear, 14. These guys are supposed to be testing out these conditions. They're racing.
You've got to push to get heat in the tyres. If you don't have heat in the tyres in these conditions, it's very, very easy to crash out of the race. That looked like Petrucci getting up the inside of Zarco. So Danilo Petrucci's getting really, really aggressive on this first lap. It was Petrucci that picked up Zarco at turn 14. First lap then about to be completed. Lorenzo, the chief aggressor off the line. Great launch and then really aggressive up the inside of Marquez and Vinales at the first corner. Lorenzo from Marquez, Dovizioso, Vinales, Crutchlow, Petrucci in sixth place. Then it's Miller, Zarco, Alessio Spargo and Pirro, your top 10.
We ride with Marquez. This is where he went down in the wet warm-up this morning. They're through turn three, up towards his double apex right, the Rio corner of turn four. Marquez determined that Lorenzo is not going to get away. Dovizioso sizing things up nicely in third place.
Yeah, Johann Zarco just struggling to find his rhythm at the start of this race. He's been picked off now by Jack Miller as well. So Miller's up into seventh place. Zarco was in sixth at the end of that first lap, but Petrucci and Miller have been able to relegate the Frenchman back to eighth place.
Down through turn seven, again we ride with Marquez to the tricky turn eight. Yeah, aggressive move by Lorenzo at the start. Marquez has a look and think and says no, far, far too early in the race. Let's just see how these conditions settle down a bit. As Dylan was saying, the rain has now stopped so they shouldn't get worse, and it will be a long, long race.
Petrucci, I think, has just picked off Cal Crutchlow down in the turn number 9. Danilo Petrucci's flying. Has he got the drive out of Tremonto as well to sweep up the inside of Maverick Vinales through turn number 11? That would be an extremely brave move. He's not quite close enough through the fastest corner on the circuit, but Petrucci, he said before this race, with no championship to think about, he can throw caution to the wind. The kitchen sink's coming here from Petrucci. He started this race in 8th place, and he's already up inside that top 5.
And there's Jack Miller running in 7th place. We know how good he is in these conditions. There you go. There is Vinales. You've just got Petrucci behind him. Clips there of Cal Crutchlow as well. Good battle. And Jack Miller behind them. And he just, again, got the glimpse of that number 5 through the spray. Of course, that is Johan Zarco. Look at these conditions. We ride with Vinales.
The drive that Petrucci got out of the final corner was unbelievable. Vinales will have the inside line, so he'll be able to keep Petrucci at bay. But the grunt of the Ducati, and he just rides around the outside of Vinales going through turn number 2. Petrucci has got great confidence, he's got great temperature already in those Michelin rain tyres, and he started to attack now for the podium. Dovizioso next in his sights, Vinales back then to 5th.
I'll be quite happy, Vinales, to stick behind Petrucci for a bit. They're probably going to drag you along. Oh, moment there for Marc Márquez.
Just a bit, coming out of turn 5 as he squeezed the power back on. Out of the seat then for Marc Márquez. That's the first big warning sign then for the world champion. He said he was going to be careful thinking about the championship in this race. He does not want to take any crazy risks. He knows Jorge Lorenzo in front of him is not a championship contender. Here's the replay at turn 5. Yeah, big moment, big rear tyre slide for Márquez through turn 5. Got away with that one.
You're not going to get away with it all the time. Márquez has crashed out 3 times this weekend, including in the wet warm-up this morning. Lorenzo leads away, Márquez, Dovizioso, Petrucci, Vinales, Crutchlow and Miller. We have Zarco, Aleix Espargaró, Michele Pirro running in 10th place.
As we feared, oh, Crutchlow, he had a massive moment on the front end as he came through turn number 11. Cal Crutchlow did incredibly well to hang on to that LCR Honda there because he was nearly down the road.
He didn't lose any places either. Here they are down at turn 14, the first gear right. Two left-handers coming up. Lorenzo's through the first one. That's where he crashed out in 2015. I remember Jorge Lorenzo into turn 16, the Misano corner when he crosses the line. 25 laps to go. We've only had 3 in these treacherous conditions.
Yeah, Lorenzo the only man in the 148s, although Petrucci also in the 148s. Lorenzo, quickest man on track, 148.762. It's all bunching up a little bit behind Maverick Vinales. We heard from Valentino Rossi and Vinales earlier on this year. The Yamaha this year in the rain doesn't seem to have as good a grip or as good a feel as what it did in 2016. Rossi, you remember, had some great rides in the rain last year, but not happy with the performance of the bike this year. Vinales at the moment, he's struggling to go away with that top 4 in front of him.
Yeah, it's a good battle for 5th place. Crutchlow closing up on Vinales. Jack Miller right on the rear wheel of Crutchlow. Crutchlow, of course, won in mixed conditions. The Czech Republic, that first Grand Prix victory, but just a couple of Grand Prix before that.
Yeah, Jack Miller.
Oh, Miller nearly got up the inside there of Crutchlow, won in treacherous conditions in Assen.
You can see how much Crutchlow struggling for visibility, tucked in behind Maverick Vinales. On that run down through that fast kink at turn 7, Crutchlow was having to come up from out of the bubble because he just couldn't see where he was going behind the screen. He lifted his head out from behind the bubble way before the braking zone, and Crutchlow has another little twitch on the rear as well coming out of Tremonto. Cal Crutchlow, he's pushing really hard to try and find a way through on Maverick Vinales, and just making a couple of mistakes in the process.
Well, that's how the championship positions would be. It's a long, long way to go, but Vinales doesn't really want to get Miller and Crutchlow past him as we stand at the moment. He'll start dropping into the 20, over 20 points down. Early days, we've seen Jorge Lorenzo lead races before on the Ducati and then slip back with tyre wear. That's probably not going to happen today. This is Lorenzo at his best, isn't it?
Dovizioso and Petrucci are just starting to close in on Marc Márquez as well. That scare that Márquez had at turn number 5. You might just see him having a couple of laps to gather his composure back in. So there's Petrucci in 4th place. He's now the fastest man in this race, a 148.550. From Petrucci, it's Miller up the inside, that's aggressive, but Crutchlow will have the inside line through turn number 2, so we will hold firm in 6th place.
Brave stuff there, it's slippery there, we've seen so many riders go down there. Riders also going down just here, coming into turn four in the braking zone, but they're all safely through. You can see the advantage that Jorge Lorenzo has got as they go through turn six. It's a fair old advantage through the very fast turn seven.
Petrucci's got Dovizioso. Petrucci's got the better drive coming out of turn six, and he's got the inside line, the braking zone, so he's pushing Andrea Dovizioso back to third place. Danilo Petrucci then into the podium places. Keep a very close eye as well on Loris Baz, on that Realia Vincia Ducati, the two-year-old Ducati. Baz has just taken Aleix Espargaró for ninth place.
Dovizioso closes up on the rear wheel of Petrucci. So Lorenzo Marquez, Dovizioso, Petrucci. What is happening behind? Have they got past Maverick Viñales? Is he just holding him up a little bit?
You've got to feel sorry for Dani Pedrosa. We feared he might struggle getting heat into those Michelin rain tyres. He's currently circulating down in 20th place. Lorenzo's your race leader, doing a 1:48.6. Dani Pedrosa's last time around, a 1:54.1. He's over 5 seconds off the pace, is Dani Pedrosa. It's almost painful to watch him suffer so much when he can't get heat in those Michelin rain tyres.
Loris Baz is flying. There he is, coming up on the rear wheel there of Johann Zarco as Pirro starts to make a progress through. Pirro picked off Aleix Espargaró very comfortably indeed.
Petrucci now trying to hunt down Viñales. Lorenzo's gone over the line and set another fastest lap of the race, a 1:48.0. Last time around, Lorenzo was 1.2 seconds quicker than Marc Marquez, and Petrucci, he thought about that on the flip-flop in turns one and two. Petrucci, though, it's a matter of when, not if, he's going to sweep through on Marc Marquez. He's absolutely all over the rear wheel of Marc Marquez. Dylan.
Guys, sorry to butt in. Did you see Marc Marquez just gave a signal to his team off pit wall? He pushed his leg out. They are just getting his number two bike ready. I wonder whether that is maybe fitted with harder rain tyres. Keep an eye on that space.
Wow. We will wait and see.
Let's have a look. Yeah, we can see them getting ready. Is the foot coming out or does his leg...
Yeah, the foot comes out.
So he obviously feels like he's got some kind of issue, yeah, because Dovizioso now drops back as well. Does he not feel like those soft rain tyres are going to go the whole race distance? I mean,
Petrucci is opening up a gap between the two of them. Can Petrucci close down that big, big gap we have at the front with Jorge Lorenzo? There is Lorenzo. We ride with the man that's won here four times previously. He's only been off the podium once. This is Petrucci, Rainmaster, Marquez and Dovizioso. Miller and Crutchlow have both got past Maverick Viñales, and Miller has got past Crutchlow.
Guys, I'm just going to keep speculating here. I reckon this is Marquez maybe telling his team, I think this track is going to dry out. All the second bikes are prepared for wet conditions, and he might be thinking, I might be needing slicks later on, so they are now just changing the bike around.
Well, he's the master tactician, isn't he, when it comes to flag races, Marc Marquez. I think he's won five of the last six flag-to-flag Grand Prix. He's such a clever thinker in these kind of conditions, isn't he, Marquez? Looking at it now, you can't believe he's going to get dry. Was there just a hint of a dry line as they came over the line? There's still a lot of spray being kicked up. There is a long way to go, 22 laps.
Just trying to see what tyre they are.
That was a rain tyre, because they'd have had his second bike fitted for with rain tyres just in case he had a problem with the number one bike coming to the line or on the warm-up lap. So they're obviously trying to get it fitted up with slicks. I know Dylan's going to be basically pitching his tent now outside Repsol Honda just to make sure he doesn't miss a thing.
Well, Petrucci was in a little bit hot. Springs being changed, everything.
Petrucci got in a little bit hot there at turn four. Crutchlow's down. Gael Crutchlow had passed Maverick Viñales. That's a Ducati. It's Lorenzo. I wasn't quite sure that it was Dovizioso or Lorenzo, but Lorenzo's crashed out of the lead. He just set the fastest lap of the race, a 1:47.807. There's going to be no fairy tale first Ducati win in Italy for Jorge Lorenzo, and Cal Crutchlow also down the road.
Guys, Maverick Viñales, there's also movement now in his box. It looks like the Yamaha is also being converted to dry.
Jorge Lorenzo walks away. He's won here four times. He's not going to win this time round. Let's have a look. Ooh, what a big, big crash for Jorge Lorenzo.
On the gas. Oh, you'd think it was on the gas coming out of turn number six. Cal Crutchlow has managed to rejoin the race. Lorenzo was pushing. There's no doubt about it. There's been a couple of laps lately where he's been over a second faster than the chasing pack behind him. So it now means that Danilo Petrucci is leading here in Misano for the Pramac Ducati team. Marquez hunting menacingly in second place. Dovizioso right there as well, still in third.
Wow, the whole complexion of the race has changed in one lap, hasn't it? It appears that Crutchlow may be at the get, certainly in the top three. Lorenzo running away at the front, and it is all changed around.
Sorry to butt in, guys. This is triggered off a bit of a chain reaction now. Danilo Petrucci's team also getting the carbon discs out and the slicks. And I do reckon this is now going to start happening across the entire grid because it is not raining anymore and the sky is getting brighter.
Yeah, but there's 20 and a
there's
half.
So there's so much water out there. Well, let's have a look at the lap times. Maverick Vinales' pole time was a 1:32.4. They're 16 seconds off of the pace that they were setting in qualifying yesterday. Here's Crutchlow's crash. What happened to the LCR Honda rider? This is through turn two. Oh, he lost it. Ooh, chucked over the high side there. Cal Crutchlow going through turn number three.
Joe Ceccanello looks on. Team manager back at the front. Danilo Petrucci chasing that first ever Grand Prix victory. He was second at Silverstone. He was second at Assen this year, Silverstone, a couple of years back. And he was third in Mugello. Loris Baz, these are the rain masters. Oh,
absolutely.
Loris Baz and Jack Miller, both of them love the rain. And look at Baz, he's got up the inside.
He made that look easy. He made that look like Loris Baz was on a slick tyre, on a slick track with Jack Miller on the wet. Although he did get a little bit hot, Loris Baz, to be fair to him, and ran it a little bit wide. But he has got superb pace, Loris Baz. He was much, much quicker. Jack Miller was running a 1:52 last lap, so I think Miller might have made a mistake because he dropped back behind Maverick Vinales. So Miller was obviously caught out by a mistake, but Loris Baz swimming all over him. This is your top three. Petrucci from Marquez and from Andrea Dovizioso. So that is now going to be a full dry bike setup for Marquez.
Absolutely brilliant spot, Dylan.
Twitch by Petrucci there as well as he came out of turn 16. You can see on the straight, they're still kicking up an awful lot of spray.
I honestly don't think, but I suppose if these tyres are okay, why just not prepare for if there is an emergency at the end there? 5 points would be the gap in the championship. Do you know, I don't think Dovizioso would say that is the end of the world, do you?
No, not at all. Andrea Dovizioso, his first mission is to make sure he sees the chequered flag. He doesn't want to chuck away any crucial world championship points. Don't think he'll take any crazy risk trying to hunt down Danilo Petrucci. It's Petrucci of this top three that can take all the risks. He's not fighting for the world championship. He's trying to win his first ever Grand Prix. Talk about kudos as well, doing it here in Misano for Ducati.
19 and a half laps to go. They splash their way through the puddles down towards turn eight.
A very quick word, guys. From the top six riders, okay, the only bikes that I've not seen being changed at all in pit lane are those of Jack Miller and Andrea Dovizioso. Now, when I checked beforehand, they all looked like they were wet, but Dobby's bike is so covered up that I cannot tell if it is wet or dry. But Dobby's team is not reacting at the moment.
I've got to say, I'd be really surprised, but we've been surprised before the way Marc Marquez performed in Bruno when he changed things.
Yeah, I mean, Mark,
we all thought he'd made a big mistake.
I guess he just wants them to be ready just in case that scenario comes for the last two or three laps. You know, if it does dry out in certain parts of the circuit, those rain tyres will get chewed up very, very quickly. I mean, Marquez on the last lap did his fastest lap of the race at 1:48.7, but it's still a million miles away from the best times we saw on slick tyres yesterday.
Maverick Vinales still in fourth place. Miller, Baz, Pirro, Zarco, Barbara and Aleix Espargaró. Redding, Rins, Lowe's. Good ride by Sam Lowe's in 30th. Olga, Espargaró, Iannone, Smith, Rabat, Batista, Pedrosa and Cal Crutchlow back in the race. And Karel Abraham actually back in the race as well.
Petrucci and Marquez last time around doing almost identical lap times at 1:48.1 for the pair of them. Petrucci the marginally faster by about 0.06 of a second. Here's Maverick Vinales at the moment, still in fourth place, coming under real pressure from Jack Miller and Loris Baz. There's crucial world championship points at stake there. Michele Pirro's also coming into contention too. Vinales was quite a lot slower last time around than Miller and Baz behind him too, so he's going to get swallowed up pretty quickly here as the Spaniard.
Yeah, these are vital world championship points at stake. And again, what do? Do you take risks? Or do you settle for the points when that gap will open up a little bit on Vinales from the two men at the front, especially if they finish first, second or third?
Oh, Baz has gone down. Loris Baz has gone down. His hopes have ended then. Baz down at turn number eight. He charged through from 15th place on the grid, but it's game over for Loris Baz. He won't be getting anywhere near close to equaling that brilliant fourth place he had here a couple of years ago in that flag-to-flag race.
Coming into turn eight, just dips in a little bit. loses the front end of the Ducati. Loris Spasso's race is not over. Any chance he had of picking up a lot of points or even fighting anywhere near the podium have disappeared. Back at the front, Petrucci still leads the way from Marquez.
One less for Maverick Vinales to worry about now, with Loris Baz out of contention for that fourth place. Looks like Dovizioso just being dropped here ever so slightly by Petrucci and Marquez. Loris Baz has rejoined the race.
Danilo Petrucci, nobody will forget Silverstone a couple of years ago when he was so, so close to beating Valentino Rossi in the wet conditions.
Yeah, they're still doing 148s, even though we've not got any more rain. The track not really drying up to improve the lap times that significantly. You can see a stream of water there as well running across the track in between turn two and three.
And I think, guys, that's the reason why Dobby's team hasn't reacted. I've just double-checked again, and so his second bike is definitely not set up for the dry.
Through turn four they come. Oh, another little wiggle there from Art Marquez as they come through this fast six. It's caught out of a lot of riders through the kink seven, down into eight, where we saw Loris Baz go down on the last lap.
Yeah, Loris Baz did remount. Andrea Dovizioso not making any big inroads into this lead two. He's 1.5 seconds behind Petrucci, 1.2 seconds behind Dovizioso. This is another moment smaller than what he had earlier in the race, but a couple of warnings for Marquez as he gets on the gas coming out of turn number five.
Back at the front, Petrucci still leads the way through the Tremonti corner up towards Cravone. Flat out right-hander. There is Dovizioso. Comfortable in third place, elected to use the aerodynamic fairing once the rain started to pour down on the circuit this morning. Throughout the practice sessions in the dry, he used the old fairing. Did well, he qualified in the middle of that front row of the grid.
Yeah, Dovizioso, you know what he's going to be doing right now. He's just going to be in studious mode, studying exactly what Petrucci and Marquez are doing. He's the thinking man's rider. He'll be calculating the grip levels. We know even in the wet conditions, Andrea Dovizioso, such a smooth rider. He'll be trying not to maybe burn up too much of his rear tyre while he's trying to hang into this battle between Petrucci and Marquez. Maybe mount a stronger challenge a little bit later on. There's still such a long way to go. 17 laps to go in actual fact. There's Marquez's second bike then, fitted with those slick tyres.
Is it a... I don't know.
I just don't think it's going to dry up.
Is it a game to unsettle the other team?
I totally understand why they're doing it, because he wants to be ready in case it does dry up. But right now, you can't see it being the case. I mean, nobody as yet has been able to fire in a 147 for quite some time. Lorenzo was able to do that, but getting to that pace, he crashed out straight away. Dylan?
Yeah, of course, one of the dangers is, a bit like Loris Baz, he's remounted. If he wanted to come in now because something like a foot peg was broken, well, his second bike is now set up for the dry.
That's exactly right, Dylan. It's a gamble. Flam up Ducati look on anxiously. Their man leads the way. Maverick Vinales in fourth place. As he stands at the moment, I think he'd probably have to settle for that. He doesn't want to be picked off, certainly by Jack Miller or Kaylee Pirro, to go further down the field and drop further back of that leading duo in the championship. Just got a glimpse of Miller and Pirro. 16.5 laps to go here. It's not raining anymore, but the track is still very wet indeed.
Yeah, Vinales just set his fastest lap of the race, just to give himself a bit of breathing space between Miller and Pirro, who were hunting him down. It'd be good for Andrea Dovizioso's championship challenge if Pirro could get ahead of Maverick Vinales.
That's quite a big ask, but Pirro knows his way around here very well indeed. There he is, you just saw him, the test rider for Ducati. Dovizioso was singing his praises yesterday. Behind Jack Miller, he is a former Grand Prix winner, he's a medal 2 winner. Kaylee Pirro back at the front. Not a lot to change, does it?
No, and they're still in
still
in the 148s, so they're not really significantly lowering their lap times. Petrucci, Jack Miller just putting a good lap as well. He's not letting Maverick Vinales having all his own way in that fourth place. Miller just putting his personal best lap of the race, a 148.357. Gap between Vinales and Miller just hovering over 0.3 seconds. Hector Barber's crashed out of this Grand Prix, so the two of Vinci Ducatis have had a bit of a nightmare. He's taken a bit of a whack on his right hip as well there, Hector Barber.
Limps away, Hector Barber. What is his future? What is the future? Oh, that is a big old crash for Hector Barber.
Yeah, final corner.
Final corner. Petrucci still leads the way. Come through turn eight up towards the double apex right that brings them onto the back straight. Certainly the conditions are a lot better, but certainly there's an awful lot of spray out there. That is the gap. They come up towards the Cavoni corner halfway through the lap, so 15 and a half laps remaining. We're not even at half distance yet.
Yeah, I suppose you could argue that while it's not raining, there's no extra water falling. While the riders are running around this course, it is going to be dispersing water off that racing line, drying it up reasonably quickly. Although you can see from Alex Rindt, Sam Lowe's the background there, still a fair bit of spray being kicked up as you sweep through Cavoni.
Yeah, 10th for Alex Rindt and 11th for Sam Lowe's. And here is Johan Zarco. Perhaps, well, he's running in 7th place, but he's a little bit back from the battle between Vinales, Miller and Pirro.
Yeah, I thought we might have seen a little bit more from Scott Redding. He's normally very adept in these conditions. He's running inside the top 10, which is pretty respectable when you think he's come from 19th on the grid, but there's been a few crashes out in front of him. He's trying to hunt down Johan Zarco. Vinales again got into a decent rhythm now, Maverick Vinales. Just set another personal best lap of the race, a 1:48.425. Not giving Jack Miller a chance to show him a front wheel as yet. Zarco also flying. He's just done a 1:49.0. That's his best lap of the race too.
Well, as we said, we're not even at half distance, and riders now fully aware of how the conditions are, probably realising as we stand alone they're not going to get any worse. Just pushing on a little bit more. Yeah, Vinales, I don't think he's not going to catch the three at the front unless there's an extraordinary change of fortune. But his job now is to hang on to fourth place and those precious points.
It's hard to gauge as well just how fast this Misano circuit dries. It got resurfaced a couple of years ago in 2015, and since then we've had very, very little wet track time. So there's not a lot of experience for the teams and riders to base their judgment on in terms of, well, give it another 5 or 6 laps and it probably will start drying up very, very quickly. That's also adding to the conundrum.
Bradley Smith getting up the inside of his teammate Paul Espargaró. That would do his confidence a little bit of good. And there's Andrea Iannone in front of the two KTM riders. That's Smith moving up into 14th place. An important move for that. And his
really
future.
Important move, yeah. Bradley Smith has seemingly been a little bit vulnerable. Big race coming up in 2 weeks' time for him, with Mika Kallio rejoining the KTM team as a wild card in Aragon. Scott Redding has picked up another place. He's ahead of Aleix Espargaró up into 8th. Here's Dani Pedrosa, who's having a real nightmare. He's doing 1:53s. Which is over 5 seconds off of the best pace. Oh, Aleix Espargaró has gone down as well.
So Aleix Espargaró down, he was running in 9th place. Just pushes the, well, obviously it does, but just pushes those guys up who were soldiering on behind him to pick up some really important points.
Next, pushed his teammate Sam Lowe's up into the top 10, which would be Sam Lowe's first top 10 finish of the season. In fact, it would only be his second point scoring ride of a pretty troubled 2017. Of course, we know Sam Lowe's heading back to Moto2 next year. Pretty much as you were at the front between Petrucci, Marquez and Dovizioso.
They're all certainly Marquez and definitely Dovizioso. Guys that have just worked this situation out. Petrucci is quite hard for him, isn't it? Running at the front with these two guys behind him. But yeah, he's very, very accomplished in these conditions. He's obviously not quite sure what they've got left in the tank. We're not sure what he's got left in the tank. Yeah, dry setup. Well done, Dylan. Brilliant spot.
So Petrucci then now through Cavoni on lap 15. We're halfway through this Misano Grand Prix.
So how hard, when it comes to the when it comes down to the nitty-gritty, are Marquez and Dovizioso going to push with so many important points at stake?
MotoGP riders, aren't they?
Yeah, they're still with a wet setup. Andrea Dovizioso.
Well, you think the Catty would have the local knowledge, wouldn't you, in terms of understanding the track conditions?
Yeah, listen, this is as you were at the moment. This is just a formation flying. They are just sussing out the conditions, just how hard they can push, working out in their heads as well.
Marquez had another twitch.
He's had 3 moments now, and it's going to make him think, isn't it?
Turn two, Again, another twitch. It drops him back right into the clutches of Dovizioso, who's picking up his pace, Andrea Dovizioso. Last time around, at 1:48.019 was his fastest lap of the race. Maverick Viñales again improves down to 1:48.3. Yeah, that's the third time Marc Marquez has had that rear tyre sliding and slipping like a snake underneath him.
And even if you're Marc Marquez, you can't keep doing it, can you? In these conditions, you will go down in the end.
Yeah, Dovizioso looks pretty threatening now in that third place. Got down to a low 1:48 last time around.
We ride with Dovizioso, so there is Marquez in front of him. They just look comfortable behind him at the moment.
Got to say, Viñales is doing an outstanding job of holding off Miller and Pirro. Miller's now dropped at 6 tenths. Oh, Sam Lowes, who was heading for his first top 10. Well, he's down at turn 4. That's his 5th crash of the weekend. So a bad home Grand Prix for the factory Aprilia team, with Aleix Espargaró out of the race. And Sam Lowes, here we are at turn number 4.
Oh, that's desperate for poor old Sam Lowes. His confidence is zero. He's out of the team at the end of the season. He's having a great ride, and he's crashed out again. All you can do is really feel great sorrow for him, can't you?
It didn't really look like he was pushing too
aggressively,
did it?
No,
really,
it didn't.
Sam Lowes, one of those mistakes that you get caught out very easily on these rapidly changing track conditions. Petrucci then to chalk another one off the list. Lap 17 underway. Just under half a second, he is clear of Marc Marquez. Dovizioso still looking a big threat there in third place. Almost identical lap times for them last time around. 1:48.5 from Petrucci, 1:48.6 from Dovizioso, and a 1:48.7 from Marquez.
So compare them, we ride with Marc Marquez. Right in his face, as you can see, is the Ducati of Andrea Dovizioso. Closes right up on him. Through turn 4. And then this is his fast turn 6, and it's got out a lot of riders here. And then you race, it's not really the back straight, there's a little kink in the middle, as you will see. Put them off in any way at all, but then turn 8, it sucks you in, it just drops into the left-hander here. Brilliant onboard stuff, we're riding with Marquez. Dovizioso is just looking comfortable behind him. They come into the Tremonto curve that leads onto that back straight.
I've got to say, there are some parts of the track that look like they are drying up fairly quickly.
Yamaha have now pushed Viñales' bike into position. They are now possibly expecting it.
11 and a half to go. It's getting me to really look hard now. Here is Maverick Viñales. He's done a really good job in fourth place, Maverick Viñales, because he knows if Jack Miller gets near him, he'll be all over it, won't he? But he hasn't let him do that, and he knows how good Jack Miller is in the wet.
Doesn't want to be losing more world championship points, does he, Maverick Viñales? These two are great mates. They used to share a motorhome when they first came to MotoGP. That was a short-lived experiment. I think Maverick wanted to get a bit more sleep at night.
Poor old Maverick. He liked it in the week, but race weekend, it found a bit difficult.
There's absolutely nothing between the top three again over the line. Hundreds of seconds splitting them as they cross the line to start lap number 18. Just half a second covering that top three. Michele Pirro just struggling to run the pace of Miller, and Viñales in front of him. He's dropped back over a second behind those two, although he's upped his own pace, and Miller has dropped into the 147s. The only other rider we've seen so far in this race that was in the 147s was our early leader, Jorge Lorenzo, who of course crashed right here, high-siding out of the lead at turn 6.
Down through turn 7 they come towards 8. 10 and a half laps to go. The fuse has been lit, but this race has not exploded just yet. It will, or will it? Because perhaps Marquez and Dovizioso will say we're taking no risk. It's too big a risk.
Andrea Iannone's in.
Andrea Iannone in. Looks like problems are with the Suzuki for Iannone. I'm sure he's not coming in to change tyres now.
No, everybody was keeping a real good look though at Andrea Iannone. Yeah, problems for that just sums up an absolutely shocking weekend for Andrea Iannone. His 21st place on the grid was his worst qualifying since Valencia way, way back in 2011 when he was in the Moto2 World Championship. He said he's never felt so slow. It's tough to watch Andrea Iannone. He's struggling so much on that factory Suzuki right now.
This is Zarco running in seventh place. Just behind him, you saw Scott Redding. coming into view, the man that's won here twice, Alex Rins, Moto 3 winner to a Canyon. Then it's Folger, then it's Smith, Paul Espargaro, Rabat Batista, and then Loris Paz has got back in the points in 15th place.
So yeah. Marquez then has dipped into the 147s, personal best lap of the race from the world championship, or the reigning world champion.
It's just burning, isn't it? It's just gently
slow
simmering.
Boil right. That's now, right. Is it simmering?
But will it explode? I cannot believe that Marc Marquez will not try and win the race. Davizioso will want to win it, but Davizioso may feel, well, if it's a third or even a second place, that will do very nicely as far as the championship goes. When we arrive in Aragon in 2 weeks' time, hopefully the weather will be an awful lot better.
Petrucci's doing an outstanding job at the front of this race. It's not easy when you keep coming over the line and seeing plus 4 or plus 0.4, 93. He knows Marc Marquez is right there with him as Andrea Iannone starts the post-race investigation into why he's had to withdraw on that factory Suzuki.
At the front, into Tremonte, far end of the circuit, 9.5 to go.
Sorry guys, just getting word from the Suzuki box, it's actually an arm pump problem for Iannone.
Many thanks, didn't Loris Paz has crashed for the second time. At that point he was going to pick up in 15th place has now disappeared.
And there's Petrucci, looks like he's stretched out a couple of tenths here on Marc Marquez on this lap number 19. Yeah, two crashes for Loris Paz then. Tough for him to take when he would have expected a chance to have fought inside that top six. He was charging through the field, but kind of struggles now getting the point scoring places.
You're so right, Matt. It's a great ride by Petrucci. He's never won a Grand Prix. He's run at the front, what, for three quarters of this race now. He's got two of the great riders behind him. He's riding a very solid race at the front.
Don't want to be commentator's curse, but so far he's been immaculate. He has not got his wheels out of line. In fact, he's just come over the line and set his own personal best lap of the race, a 1:48 flat from Petrucci.
Perhaps he can feel now he may be just to push him a little bit hard behind. We've seen, what, three moments for Marc Marquez, and he knows that Davizioso is leading the championship. He puts the hammer down now with just under nine laps to go. He may be the one up the advantage. Oh,
Pirro
is closing up now on Miller. Miller's in trouble. Pirro is through.
Jack Miller. He's wide at turn four, he obviously was, because Pirro's swept on through. What's the gap between Vinales and Pirro? Almost 3 seconds, that's quite a big gap to bridge. Miller thinks about a fight up the inside again of Pirro down at turn number eight. Although it hasn't rained for a while, the track's sort of remained in a stagnant condition, hasn't it? The lap times haven't improved at all. We've seen sort of deviations over the last sort of 10 laps of only 3, 4, 5 tenths of a second. So it's not improved the extent that we might have anticipated.
These are two riders chasing for a single world championship point. And Danny Pedrosa and Cal Crutchlow.
How really humbling is that for Danny Pedrosa? Cal Crutchlow's crashed. Cal Crutchlow's crashed in this race, and he's still been able to remount and find his way through back on Danny Pedrosa. Pretty humbling experience for Pedrosa, that one.
Just when Petrucci perhaps thinks he's opening up at a bit of an advantage, it's closed up again a bit, isn't it? It's pretty standard stuff at the moment. Over 8 laps to go, so cross the line. We'll be able to go when they do cross the line. They've done that now.
Petrucci's really running a fantastic race. He's just put in the fastest lap of the race, a 1:47.697. Immediately followed by 1:47 from the two men leading the chasing pack, Marquez and Davizioso. He can't break away from the two championship contenders behind him.
Great shot. Still pretty wet out there, isn't it, as you can see. Good look at Marquez.
It's all going to come down to the risk-reward ratio for these two men in your picture right now, Marquez and Davizioso. How much are they willing to gamble? How much are they willing to put on the line to try and defeat Danilo Petrucci? Petrucci's not in the championship picture at all. They don't have to worry about him in terms of fighting his way back into championship contention. But trying to beat him means it's going to be increasing the risk levels. Will they roll the dice and go for it?
It's a difficult one. 7.5 laps to go. Tension in the Pramac Ducati garage. Danilo Petrucci chasing his first win. He's had a third place this year in Mugello at the Italian Grand Prix. Second in Assen. Second a couple of years back at Silverstone in England. He's never going to get a better chance than this to win a Grand Prix race.
Would be a fantastic victory as well for Petrucci. Had to climb off his sick bed on Friday morning just to jump on that Pramac Ducati. Hardly got any sleep at all on Thursday night. He's been struggling with a flu bug for most of this week. Oh, Tito Rabat's gone down the road, so Tito Rabat's out of this race. Another one to perish in these tricky conditions.
Tito Rabat walks away, as have many others. The main one, Jorge Lorenzo, when he was leading the race quite comfortably, went down on the Ducati.
Turn six, pretty much exactly the same crash that happened to his fellow Spanish rider, Jorge Lorenzo, when Lorenzo was leading. Marquez now has set the fastest lap of the race, a 1:47.549. Now, the last time around, Petrucci and Marquez took half a second out of Andrea Dovizioso.
Marquez, is he sizing him up? 1:47.549, as Matt said. 6.5 laps to go. It's the difference of 5 points, isn't it? You know, you get 25 for a win and 20 for a second.
Marquez is just leaving it all out there, isn't he? He's laying everything on the table here. Dovizioso, I don't know whether Dovizioso is running out of grip or whether he's just going, putting the shutters down for the winter here, whether he's just settling for those crucial 16 points. We know that Marc Marquez, he's got that cavalier approach sometimes. He's going to go for it, isn't he?
Do you know, I think he is. And I think perhaps Dovizioso is going to say, right, let them go for it. I'll take the points. This is Maverick Viñales. He would look back and you say, well, fourth place couldn't have been a great run. I think he's ridden quite brilliantly in these conditions. He really settled into it, didn't he?
Yeah, he never gave Miller or Pirro a chance at showing him their front wheel, and now he's a pretty comfortable 2.6 seconds clear of Pirro in that fourth place. Another great ride by Michele Pirro to take a fifth spot, and he's pulled away quite comfortably from Jack Miller, actually. 1.4 seconds the gap now between Pirro and Miller in fifth and sixth.
Time is not running out, but it's getting closer and closer, because if they cross the line, there will be six laps to go over this round 13 of the MotoGP World Championship. Here is the championship leader, and even if Marquez wins the race, if it's so, will still lead the championship. Danilo Petrucci at the front wants to win his first Grand Prix, and he will do absolutely everything to prevent Marquez winning this race.
Well, he keeps showing whatever Marc Marquez has got, he retaliates and some. He's just set the fastest lap of the race, a 1:47.537. Andrea Dovizioso, I think, is out of this in terms of the victory challenge. We're on board with Petrucci then through turn five now. Marquez won't let him go, though. The gap just under half a second. Dovizioso's dropped 2.2. Petrucci, a warning as he came through turn six. He was littered out of the seat as he got on the gas. A bit of a rear tyre slide for Petrucci. That's the first real mistake we've seen him make. It wasn't a small mistake. Eerie me, speedway style for Petrucci. First mistake he's made.
If ever Marquez wanted to make his mind up, that could be the moment for Marc Marquez. He thinks, right, I'm going to have a go at Gigi Delini.
Gigi Delini's got a few more grey hairs.
He can't get a lot more.
That was speedway star by Petrucci. Yeah, Dovizioso's hopes of a victory here in Misano are gone. It looks like if the Ducati going to take a first win in 10 years here in Misano, Casey Stoner, their last victor in Misano back in 2007. It looks all down to Danilo Petrucci now.
Boy, Lorenzo was leading the race and he crashed out at turn six. Looks on.
Yeah, he's perfectly okay, but he's not going to be a happy spectator watching this. This is on board with Lorenzo. He's coming through turn five. His race is going to last one more corner more. Oh, that's a big old crash, wasn't it, for Lorenzo? Fine margins, aren't they? Lorenzo has a moment in turn six and gets flown to the scenery. Danilo Petrucci has one and just plops back in the seat. Marquez is really seriously stalking Petrucci now, isn't he?
Five laps to go. Classic race in treacherous conditions. Petrucci chasing that first Grand Prix win. Marquez chasing his fourth Grand Prix win of the season to close the gap on Dovizioso, who seems to have settled for third place
and what
in the championship.
What happens
battle.
If Marquez takes Petrucci? We go to Aragon, level on points with Dovizioso. The gap's 9 points, is it, between the two of them?
It is. And that's
they'll go level
points.
On points.
Yep.
Wow. Petrucci's going to have a big part to say in that, though, in these final 4.5 laps here in Misano. He's withstood everything that Marc Márquez has had to throw at him so far, but you know Marc Márquez, there's still more to come.
Through turn eight they come. 4.5 laps to go, down towards the Tremonti curve. It's a right-hander that leads onto the back straight. Petrucci has done all the donkey work at the front in the rain, although sometimes in the rain, certainly in the early stages of the race, it's probably the best place to be in the spray. Now it is a lot better. Andrea Dovizioso, you get the feeling he feels right. Precious points, and that would do me in third place. He's won the last two races. To finish on the podium again, I think will be a decent job done.
Yeah, just wondering whether Dovizioso might just be struggling for grip now as the track does dry out by a fraction every single lap. I think, yeah, he's definitely gone into safety mode now, Dovizioso. Make sure he takes those crucial 16 points. He'll be focusing ahead because he knows if Petrucci wins his first ever Grand Prix in famous fashion, then Dovizioso will still go to Aragon, lead the World Championship. He knows that if Márquez sneaks through, and it's all square going to Aragon.
And both on 4 Grand Prix wins as well. Then you're looking at, aren't you, second place.
Podium or something, yeah.
Yeah, that's right. Won't really matter, will it?
I've got to say, though, hats off to Marc Márquez because he doesn't need to... Petrucci's not his championship rival. He's desperate to win this Grand Prix, isn't he, Marc Márquez? He's giving his all, despite the risk. I mean, a DNF here for Marc Márquez is going to be catastrophic for his championship chances, but he's laying it all out there now.
I think this is the only way he really knows how to ride.
Absolutely. Well, if he doesn't push, he crashes, doesn't he?
Yeah,
if he loses focus, if he loses concentration, that's when the mistakes start to creep in. You've got to keep at your absolute razor-edge best. And I've got to say as well, despite all the pressure, and there is severe pressure coming from Marc Márquez, who's one of the fastest and most aggressive riders in World Championship history, the job that Petrucci has done, not to give him a sniff of taking the lead, has been absolutely phenomenal.
Through the Tremonti curve, 3.5 laps to go here in Misano. The rain has stopped, the track is still wet. We ride with the Pramac Ducati rider through the Curvoni corner. Have a look what sort of speed they're going through that today. About 220-230 kilometers an hour. Now you're going, gets tighter and tighter through this series of right-handers before you come to the first gear right-hander at turn 14. Márquez closes up on the brakes. Two left-handers to come. Turn 15. And now turn 16, the Misano corner into the start and finish straight where they cross the line. 3 to go.
Pramac Ducati and Danilo Petrucci were absolutely ecstatic when he was on the podium in Mugello. Imagine if he wins now here in Italy. Yeah. An even shorter press release that time. That was a pretty short press release when they took that third place. Márquez is closing, isn't he? That's as close as he's been for a number of laps. He's under 0.2 seconds behind Petrucci. He stalked his prey for a number of laps now, Marc Márquez. Is he about to go in for the kill?
So Loris Bazzi's crashed twice. They've just passed. Lap. Márquez right on the rear wheel now of Danilo Petrucci. Coming through turn 6, we've seen Lorenzo go down here, we've seen Rabat go down here, they're both safely through. Petrucci had a big moment here a couple of laps ago. Through the little kink, turn 7, down to 8.
This is a real test of Petrucci's mettle now. Through 8, 2.5 laps to go. Márquez continues to keep the hammer down. Will not give Petrucci 1 millisecond to relax at the front of this race. Closes up then now into the top end of the circuit. Tremonti turn 10 as they'll start firing that Ducati and Honda down the long back straight towards Curvoni corner.
Is he now thinking about the championship in any way, or is it all one thought, I'm going to win the race?
I think when he's this close with 2.5 laps to go, the championship's probably occupying about 3% of his brain right now. The rest is 97% gung-ho going for the win.
Márquez once again closes up on the brakes as they come down to turn 14. The last of the right-handers. Up through 15 and 16.
Petrucci looks like he's definitely got a little bit of an advantage in terms of drive grip coming out in the corners. Then Márquez closes up a lot on the brakes. Sort of concertina effect.
Through 16, across the line. 2 laps to go here at Misano. Can Danilo Petrucci win his first Grand Prix? Can Marc Márquez go to Aragon in 2 weeks' time, equal on points with Andrea Dovizioso? We are going to find out any moment now. Here comes Márquez.
He's he's going to attack. He's going to attack, there's no doubt about it. If he can get close enough, it's Marc Márquez, of course, he's going to attack. Kashimine's back to the Red Bull ring. Petrucci runs a pretty tight defensive line through turn number four. He will be able to hear Marc Márquez's Repsol Honda breathing all over his neck. We know Marquez is going to attack. Look what happened at the Red Bull ring when he lunged up the inside of Vizioso at the final corner. A really ambitious move. He's going to strike. Is he close enough to attack at turn eight on the brakes? No, he's not.
No, takes the outside line. Get good drive out though, won't he, Marc Márquez?
He will. Petrucci is just riding so defensively. He cut it tight to the inside at turn four. He cut it tight as well on the inside at turn number eight. Just slamming the door shut on Marc Márquez.
What about turn 14 when they break that tight first gear right handle? Can Márquez be close enough? They come onto the back straight. 1.5 laps to go. Petrucci's so close for that first ever Grand Prix victory. But Márquez is closing all the time through 12, through 13, coming up to 14.
He's not going to be close enough. Here they come then through 13, although he does really, really close up Marc Márquez. He's not tight enough though to Petrucci. He's getting a real good look here though to assess Petrucci's strengths and weaknesses. Through turn 15 on the penultimate lap. Just one lap and one corner to go then for Petrucci and Márquez. Will Márquez sweep to the inside this time around? No, he won't. Petrucci though will be hearing him like a clap of thunder in his ears now.
We arrive with Danilo Petrucci. Marc Márquez in his face. Here comes Márquez up the inside on the brake. They break into turn one. Marc Márquez takes the lead on the last lap.
Marc Márquez then hits the front for the first time. Can he hold off Petrucci through turn two? Right then now through turn three. What has Petrucci got in response? Turn four coming up now. Petrucci, can he have a look up the inside of Márquez? He thinks about it, but no, he's not quite close enough. Márquez holds firm.
Up at turn four, double apex. Oh. Right, Márquez is running a little bit wide, but Petrucci follows him as well.
God, look
through the very fast turn six, it looked like they were both drifting.
Oh, look like Petrucci took the front going into turn number four. Did that cost Danilo Petrucci? Marc Márquez then, he'll run that tight defensive line down into turn number eight. Petrucci, I think he took the front, had a big moment on the front end going through turn number four. That might have been costly. Petrucci desperately trying to cling on to Marc Márquez, but Marc Márquez now coming up to turns nine and 10. His advantage probably around 0.4 of a second.
I think it's enough. Through the Tremonti curve, they come. Accelerate up into sixth gear. Well over 250 kilometres an hour. Márquez for the first time leads the race. I think poor old Petrucci, who's done all the donkey work at the front, is going to have to settle for second place.
It's going to need a massive mistake now by Marc Márquez to bring Petrucci back into contention. Márquez has surely got this one covered. He leads by 0.4 of a second, runs a really tight defensive line through turn number 14. Petrucci's not going to be close enough. Márquez surely's got this one in his hand. We're going to be going to Aragon with the World Championship tied. Level on points, Marc Márquez and Andrea Dovizioso. One corner to go. He does not get any closer than this in the MotoGP World Championship.
Marc Márquez, last corner, crosses the line. They're equal on points as he wins here in Misano with Dovizioso.
What a lap.
In third by Márquez,
the fastest lap of the race on the last lap, a 47.0. Unbelievable by Marc Márquez. Andrea Dovizioso takes the podium finish for the first time here in Misano. We go to Aragon with Marc Márquez and Andrea Dovizioso tied at the top of the championship on 199 points. A last lap from the gods by Marc Márquez. That was incredible. He was 1.2 seconds faster than Danilo Petrucci. One of the best last laps, one of the best wins of his Grand Prix career.
Absolutely superb. Vinales 4, Pirro 5, Miller 6, Redding 7, Rins in 8th place. 9th, we expect Johan Zarco to cross the line. Ah, oh, Danilo Petrucci, what a ride, what a disappointment for Petrucci.
What's happened to Johan Zarco? Has he had a problem on the last lap?
He could well
have clashed, yeah. Zarco had a tumble. Look at that, the fastest lap of the race on the last lap, 147.0. He absolutely pulverised everybody on that last lap. Petrucci in second, 1.2 seconds back. Dovizioso was 2.4 seconds slower. Zarco's having to push his bike over the line.
It's like a finish of the TT races in the Isle of Man, isn't it? The push-up bike over there. Poor old Johan Zarco. Scott Redding in seventh place. Alex Rins, eighth. Ninth, Jonas Folger. And tenth for Bradley Smith in front of his teammate, Pol Espargaró, and Alvaro Bautista in 12th. Zarco as Bautista and Crutchlow cross the line. It's still going to, no, Pedrosa's gone through. Can he pick up a point? Is he going to pick up a point? He is in 15th place. He crosses the line.
Oh.
No.
He's absolutely shattered, isn't he, Johan Zarco? The legs are going like one of those marathon runners, isn't he? When their legs go, is it just about to cross the finish line?
No, Baz has gone through and Abraham's gone through. But I think Zarco...
He's done it.
He's picked up a single World Championship point, I think. Yes, he has. Oh, what a brilliant way to pick up a point. But what a last lap.
Unbelievable.
Mark Marquez. Unbelievable. Well done, Johan Zarco.
He is absolutely
no
exhausted.
No backflips, I don't think, today for Johan Zarco.
I don't think he could do a forward roll now.
That was superb from Marquez.
Oh, absolutely brilliant.
Oh, what a great race.
So much.
You turn up every Sunday and you just do not know what is going to happen, do you?
So much to gain in winning that race. But of course, when you take the risk like Marquez does, you've got so much to lose in terms of the championship. Mark Marquez, that last lap was breathtaking. 147.0. And there you go, confirmation on your screens. We head to Aragon, five races to go. Mark Marquez and Andrea Dovizioso locked together on 199 points. I think we might be having a final round decider in Valencia in a few weeks' time.
It certainly appears to be the case. Valentino Rossi's, we saw on the television earlier, well, we saw the social media pictures, watching with his cat. He'd have been cheering for Danilo Petrucci, I think.
Well,
poor old Danilo Petrucci. He's going to talk to Dylan in a minute. Absolutely superb ride. He deserved to win, didn't he? He'd done all the hard work for everybody. But that's MotoGP for you.
He had nothing, though, did he, for Marc Marquez at the end of that race? I don't think anybody in the world, to be fair, would have had anything for Marc Marquez. They're still absolutely ecstatic. Crew chief Daniele Romagnoli looks on. Mark Marquez.
I don't think anybody would have lived with Marquez on that last lap.
No, absolutely awesome. Fantastic performance.
Well, I'll be honest with you, I didn't know what to expect before 28 laps in those treacherous conditions. Once again, we've been treated to an absolute brilliant race and a masterclass by this man.
Yeah.
Surely one of the greatest motorcycle races we've ever seen, and I don't say that blandly.
Yeah, and you can just tell Nick, by the way, he's celebrating. He knows, look, I mean, Mark Marquez, he's a pretty animated cat. You can hear him there roaring under his helmet.
Yeah.
He knows that victory was absolutely massive in terms of the World Championship. I haven't seen him celebrate a win like this for quite some time.
I think he'll say that's one of my greatest ever victories, yeah. Well done, Maverick Vinales, okay. Off the podium, but you picked up some really decent points in it, which was always going to be a difficult race for the man who started from pole position.
Yeah, the worry for Vinales and Yamaha is he was 16 and a half seconds behind the race winner, so Yamaha losing about 3-4 tenths a lap in the rain conditions. Yeah. Definitely work to do for Yamaha in those wet weather conditions.
Big hug from his dad.
Yeah, a sigh of relief as well by Marc Marquez. A test of concentration, a test of his brain power, a test of his skill, a test of his talent, and he had the answers for everything.
Enjoy watching this guy in action, because you are watching somebody so, so special. I know all the discussions we have about what happened 2 years ago and everything else. He is a very, very special MotoGP rider. That was brilliant. To put that last lap in those conditions, staggering. Danilo Petrucci, he's desperate, isn't he?
Well, I bet he's just absolutely shattered. Yeah. He's been well below at full physical fitness all weekend, and those races where it takes so much out of you mentally to keep your concentration and your focus. Great job as well by Michele Pirro.
Unsung hero, isn't he?
Yeah, absolutely.
Unsung hero, Ducati.
Could not have put it better myself, Nick. Yeah, absolutely. Petrucci looks drained, doesn't he? He gave it everything.
Dovi won't be unhappy. Dovizioso, okay. He hasn't lost the lead in the World Championship, but he just made it even more exciting. But he's picked up a podium finish. Conditions were never going to be easy. They're already sorting out what happened. They're already thinking about Aragon, hopefully in very different weather conditions. Although we've had it wet in Aragon in the past, haven't we?
We have. Yeah, I think Andrea Dovizioso, the podium will be the consolation for him. He wanted to win, of course. If he had won, he'd have been the oldest rider since Mick Doohan in 1998 to win three successive races in the Premier Class, but he is still right there in the championship.
Well, in a race like that, when there's a lot of crashes and a lot of things go on, there's always some great results for some riders. Scott Redding did a great job in seventh place. Alex Rins in eighth. Bradley Smith in tenth place. That's great for all of them, isn't it?
Yeah, and great to see younger brother Alex Marquez there coming down to join the celebrations. Alex has had a really tough weekend. He had a heavy crash in FP1 on Friday, which ruled him out of the Moto2 race. Good to see Jack Miller back inside the top six. Been a while since we've seen that for Jack Miller.
Yeah, big smile from Jack Miller. Boy, he was nervous only before the start of the race talking to Dylan.
Actually, that was only the third time Jack Miller's finished inside the top six in 44 starts. One of his others, of course, was that famous win at the Dutch TT in Assen last year. He's absolutely drained.
He's got absolutely nothing left.
I think he's probably got mixed emotions as well. Climbed off his sick bed, and he's probably a little bit sick that he wasn't able to finish that job through on Marc Marquez. But when he looks back and reflects on that race, there was nothing he could have done more.
It's not his riding, was it? No. It's the riding of Marquez that won the race.
Could not have done anything more.
Nothing more. If he'd done anything more, he'd have crashed, wouldn't he? Which he nearly did on the last lap, didn't he?
You've got to be pretty special to beat this man, wet, dry, damp, or whatever, because he is absolutely brilliant.
Three crashes this weekend.
Level on
typical Marc Marquez.
Level on Valentino Rossi now as well in terms of Premier Class wins for Honda.
Mick Doohan still leading the way. Well, I think the crowd got what they deserved. They got an absolute cracking race, because they did want to come and see Valentino Rossi in action. That is not going to be the case. Here he is, championship leader. Well, joint championship leader, Andrea Dovizioso with Dylan.
Well, Dobby, congratulations, third place here in Misano. But what are you feeling right now? You're even in the championship. You were in the fight until seven laps to go, but then you just dropped off a bit. What was the problem?
Well, for sure, everybody want to try to win every time. I was there, but I wasn't feeling so good on the bike, so the risk was too high. Everybody almost crashed today, so I think today it was a day we don't have to make a mistake, so I'm happy about the podium. I never did a podium in Misano, so we have to be happy about that. Thanks to the team, it was a very difficult weekend, but we are there and we did another podium in a strange and difficult moment. So I'm really happy. Championship, we are there, same point of Mark. Still, the championship is long.
Thanks a lot, Tommy. Congratulations.
Yeah, I think he's... Well, of course, he sums it just right. He knows exactly what he's saying. He felt he couldn't push on in those last seven laps. He picked up 16 precious World Championship points. And it hadn't been for Marquez's extraordinary last lap, he'd still be leading the championship. As it is, as far as the neutrals go, it couldn't be better, could it?
No.
He got into round 14 and they're equal on points. Still that his suit us very nicely.
Yeah, still his first podium at Misano, so he's buried that jinx in many respects.
Danilo Petrucci did all the hard work, had to settle for second place, but what a ride by the Italian.
Well, Danilo, congratulations, second place here in Misano, but you did most of the hard work. You were leading for such a long time, and just on the final lap, Mark got you. What are your emotions right now?
Mixed. Sincerely, I didn't understand at the moment I am on the podium, because I dream for all the race. Was the most difficult race of the season, and the track was very, very wet, and I tried until the last corner, but I knew Mark was behind and was studying me, but if I let him pass, I was scared about to lose him. Then at the last lap I try, but I close the steer one time, I nearly crash, and I decide to finish second. Anyway, it's a great result, but another time very, very close to the win. This time, but I have nothing to regret, but it's a second place. But anyway, thanks to everybody who is here.
Thank you very much, Danilo. Thank you. Congratulations.
What a great guy he is, Danilo Petrucci. And he will win a Grand Prix before too long.
Like he said, absolutely nothing to regret. He could not have tried any harder to win his first Grand Prix. There was that crucial mistake when he lost the front at turn four on that last lap. That was probably when it was all done and dusted. Before that, though, he produced a quite brilliant exhibition of wet weather riding. Here are his highlights. He came from eighth on the grid. Of course, the race winner here last year, Danny Pedrosa, came from eighth on the grid as well. Not quite history repeating itself. Close, though.
No, it was superb. past Marc Márquez to lead the way, and it took an extraordinary last lap from that world champion to push Danilo Petrucci back to second place. Well, another absolutely superb race and a superb performance by the Rainmaster himself, Marc Márquez, with Dylan.
Well, Mark, congratulations. Victory here in Misano, I think a very important victory. We haven't seen you celebrate this much a win for a long time. But tell us, that last lap, I mean, you got to Danilo. Were you confident you were going to win that?
You never know. On rain conditions, you never know. But I was trying to control all the race, trying to control myself, because I was able to be a little bit faster. But I say, OK, you must to be passion. And then when I saw that we start to open a gap with Dobby, one moment I thought to stay on second position, but then on the last lap, I try. I mean, this championship is really tight. 5 points can be a lot in the end. After Silverstone, it's important, really important, this victory for me, for myself, but especially for the team. And yeah, keep pushing. We have a good level, so keep riding like we do, because it's the way.
Thank you very much, Mark. Congratulations.
Yeah, we're going to be telling our grandchildren, aren't we? We saw that last lap by Marc Márquez in Misano. Here we go. This is the overtake at turn one. It's not the whole story, because Petrucci nearly got him back, didn't he, at turn four, and then made a mistake. Turn one on the last lap. Márquez leads for the first time.
Oh, well, at least he stuck to his pre-race promise yesterday of being careful if he's in the wet. Oh, dear, get a heart rate monitor on that. Yeah. Julian Márquez, because his son delivered yet another fantastic Grand Prix win. There's been a few of them now. What's that, Marc Márquez's 59th career win, his 33rd in the Premier class.
Fourth of the season, isn't it?
Yeah.
So that's Vinales 3, Vizioso 4, and of course Márquez 4 now.
Yeah, he's only 4 now, Marc Márquez, behind the late great Mike Hayward in the all-time victors list as well.
Right,
so
there you go.
Just gives you an indication of how brilliant Marc Márquez has been in his early part of his career.
Well, and Scott Redding, done his confidence a lot of good. Seventh place for Scott Redding. On his way to Aprilia next season, of course. Just showing why Aprilia signed him. Very good ride indeed by him. Track invasion. It's an organised one. It's not not like the old days when they just rip the fences down and could put a part of a Grand Prix racing now. Now it's part of Grand Prix racing. Look, I will be interested to hear what reception Marc Márquez gets from the Misano crowd.
Well, I think he was getting a bit of stick this morning when he crashed a warm-up and he had a cheeky little blowing of kisses to the
did,
crowd.
Yeah,
and in response, he giving as good as he was getting, I think.
Yeah, but he certainly gave as good as he got in that race. Yeah, great performance. Just sets things up so brilliantly now for Aragon.
Oh, we're effectively back to where we were in Qatar.
Yeah, that's right, starting all over again.
This is it now. It's a 5-round world championship.
Yeah,
for
that's
Vizioso.
Exactly right.
Maverick Vinales doing a pretty good damage limitation job. He is now, 16 points behind Dovizioso Márquez, not completely out of it.
Was it 13 points, was it?
Yeah, he lost
Dovizioso.
Yeah, he lost 3 points to Dovizioso.
Yeah, so he's done a decent job there.
Yeah, not a total disaster.
So here we go. Dovizioso first on the podium. The crowd will like that. They get a big cheer.
They'll love this as well when Petrucci comes on the podium.
Danilo Petrucci on the podium with the Italian flag in second place. Now, what sort of reception is Marc Márquez going to get from the Italian crowd after his fourth win of the season? Listen out.
Do you know what? He will not care one bit. That's just going to give him more motivation to try and win the world championship. We don't really want to sort of hear things like that, to be honest.
No, I couldn't agree with you more.
Pretty poor.
Because that was one hell of a ride by Marc Márquez. Well, Russell Honda team win the team award. Ikaron points in the World Riders' Championship. Vizioso and Marquez. 1-9-9 each. Vizioso getting a terrific reception from the crowd. Third place for Vizioso, has won the last two rounds. He's equal first in the World Championship. You would not have believed that at the start of the season in Qatar. President of Rimini making the presentation to Danilo Petrucci. What a ride by the Italian. Another second place. That Grand Prix win is not far off. But it's his fourth win of the season. With a last lap, you will never see the better of in the treacherous conditions. Perhaps not to the delight of the crowd. Marc Marquez wins here in Misano. Valet is the crew, is the crowd's chant as the Spanish national anthem. Rings out over the Adriatic coast of Italy. Valentino Rossi can probably hear this from his house in Tavuglia. This was a rain-affected Sunday. Dramatic races in Moto3 and Moto2, and an amazing last lap in MotoGP from the current world champion and the joint championship leader, Marc Marquez. You turn up every week and you honestly do not know what is going to happen next. What's going to happen in Aragon? I honestly do not know. Well done, Danilo Petrucci. You deserved a race victory. It took the ride of a genius to beat you. Fourth Grand Prix victory of the season for Marc Marquez.